Now I'd like to present our pastoral judge, Mrs. Brenda Banbury, escorted by Mr. Eric Smedhurst, the chairman of Crufts. Brenda has been passed to judge all groups and best in show by both the Kennel Club and the FCI. Judged best in show at Crufts 2006, along with the working utility and toy group on previous years. Looking forward to this momentous occasion, your judge, Mrs. Brenda Banbury. The Anatolian Shepherd Dog. The Australian Cattle Dog. The Australian Shepherd Dog. The Bearded Bonnie. The Belgian Shepherd Groenendael. The Belgian Shepherd Lake Nord. The Belgian Shepherd Malinois. The Belgian Shepherd Terbuerin. The Border Collie, the Briard, the Rough Collie, the Smooth Collie, the Estrella Mountain Dog, the Finnish Lapland, the German Shepherd Dog, the Hungarian Kuvas, the Hungarian Pulin, the Common Dog, the Lancashire Heeler, the Marama Sheepdog, Norwegian Boohunt, Old English Sheepdog, Polish Lowland Sheepdog, Pyrenean Mountain Dog, the Pyrenean Sheepdog, the Samoyed, the Shetland Sheepdog, the Swedish Valhund, the Cardigan Welsh Corgi, and the Pembroke Welsh Corgi. And I'll pass you over again to Graham Hill.
Well, thank you, Phil. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we now come to the seventh of our groups on show here at Crufts 2009, the Pastoral Group. As is the norm, the judging procedure for groups, Mrs. Banbury will have a quick look around each of our pastoral grades before she goes into the individual examination. There are 31 pastoral grades represented here in the ring tonight. Of an overall entry of 3,710 in the pastoral group here at Crufts 2009. The pastoral group is made up of breeds related to the farming of sheep or cattle. That in the main used for herding and protecting flocks of sheep or herds of cattle. Pastoral breeds and particular herding dogs have been used since the very early days of man's close association with dogs. Not only have they been used to herd sheep and cattle, of course, but other animals. And these dogs are also used to guard their owners' livestock from predators. All around the world, these breeds of dogs can be seen working with all types types of animals, from the hottest climes of Africa and northern Australia to the harsh cold temperatures of the Arctic. Dogs are used to herd and guard. You can see examples here of the group member from various breeds of varying sizes, shapes, and differing coats to suit their job, their function, the terrain and climate where they carried out their duties. And after Mrs. Banbury has had that initial look over each of the breeds present, we'll take a first look, a close look at each exhibit, check out the condition, breed appearance and characteristics. All this before examining each more closely, and she'll check every breed for confirmation, breed points, that they are healthy and fit for function. And the first of our pastoral breeds to be seen is the Anatolian Shepherd Dog. Mr. Ennis Quinney was the breed judge. There was a breed entry of 32, made by 29 exhibits. Mr. Quinney selected this male for best of breed, exhibit number 19468. The Anatolian Shepherd Dog, whose natural home is Turkey, is prized for his faithful devotion to his role as a guard for flocks of sheep or goats. As you can see here, he's a tall dog, a mastiff type. He must present an awesome sight to predators, whether they are wolves, men, either who threaten his master's flock. But 1,000 years ago, the Turkic-speaking people from Asia Minor, settled in what is now Turkey, brought with them. They're great herding dogs. That's the best of breed Anatolian Shepherd Dog, exhibit number 19468. Now we move on to the Australian Cattle Dog. Ms. M. S. Smile is the breed judge. It was a breed entry of 43 made by 36 exhibits, and this bitch was selected as best of breed, exhibit number 19512. Australian Cattle Dog was the result of 6 decades of crossbreeding. The breed's ancestors include the dingo, the blue mills, smooth collie, and the Dalmatian, and even possibly the bull terrier. The Australian Cattle Dog is used for control and driving of cattle in all environments. It's also known as the Australian Heeler, a name derived from the manner in which he maneuvers cattle, crouching low behind them, knitting on the heels to move them along. That's the best of breed Australian Cattle Dog, exhibit number 19512. And here we see the Australian Shepherd. Mrs. S. Cook was the breed judge. There was a breed entry of 145 made by 128 exhibits, and this male was selected as best of breed by Mrs. Cook. This one's exhibit number is 19517. Surprisingly enough, the Australian Shepherd does not originate in Australia. The breed is a product of the United States of America. The Australian Shepherd originated in California in the 1800s. Though his ancestors include sheepdogs from New Zealand and Australia. His origins go back to the Basque Spanish sheepdogs. And this is our best of breed Australian Shepherd, exhibit number 19517. And now we have the bearded collie. This is one of the breeds in the classical group with a large entry. And our judge, having been the referee to make the decision on this best of breed, he's already seen this one. This one is a male, exhibit number 19953. The breed was judged today by Mr. G.J. Atkins, who judged the males, and bitches by Mrs. S.M. O'Brien. The bearded collie is a breed that has a long association with Scotland and Northern England, where it was bred sheep. That's the best of breed. Bearded Collie, exhibit number 19953. And now we see the first of our Belgian Shepherd dogs, the Groenendael. It's J.F. Biddlecombe was the breed judge. There was a breed entry of 83 made by 71 exhibits. And Miss Biddlecombe selected this bitch's best of breed, exhibit number 19985. The Belgian Shepherd dog here in the United Kingdom is shown in four varieties. As I said, this is the first of those varieties, the Groenendael. Variety refers to the geographical area of origin within Belgium, which is their native country. It's used in Belgium as a sheepdog. The Belgian Shepherd dogs date back to the Middle Ages and began to separate into four varieties around 1891. That's the best of breed, Belgian Shepherd dog Groenendael, exhibit number 19985. Now we see the next variety of Belgian Shepherd dog, the Lacanoir. The breed was judged by Mrs. J. M. Andrews. It was an entry of 11 made by 10 exhibits. Mrs. Andrews selected this male as best of breed, exhibit number 20032. This is the rarest of the Belgian Shepherd dog varieties in the United Kingdom. The breed has a short, wiry type of coat, which is reddish form, as you can see. With the exception of coat colour, texture and length, the physical characteristics of the Belgian Shepherd dog are identical between the varieties. Similar to the neighbouring rough-haired Dutch Shepherd, the breed was first recognised in 1897. Here we see the best of breed Belgian Shepherd dog Lacanoir, exhibit number 20032. We see the Malinois variety of Belgian Shepherd dog. Mrs. J. M. Andrews was the breed judge. There was a breed entry of 42 made by 33 exhibits. And this bitch was selected as best of breed, exhibit number 20049. The Malinois takes its name from the Malinese in the country of origin, where this form of sheepdog is the most popular and the greatest in numbers. This variety again has its own individual coat type. Malinois possesses a shortish, firm textured coat, which may be red, fawn or grey with a black overlay. It's the best of breed Belgian Shepherd dog Malinois, exhibit number 20049. We see the last, but by no means the least, of the Belgian Shepherd dog varieties, the Turbaro. Mrs. L. E. Inden was the breed judge. There was a breed entry of 134 made by 120 exhibits. And Mrs. Inden selected this bitch's best of breed, exhibit 20162. This is the most popular of all the varieties of Belgian Shepherd dog, and is the variety most rapidly increasing in numbers within the United Kingdom. The Belgian Shepherd dog Turbaro is in temperament and in silhouette the closest to the Groenendael. This is the best of breed Belgian Shepherd dog Turbaro, exhibit number 20162. And here we see the Border Collie. This is the breed in the pastoral group, the largest entry of 472, made by 415 exhibits. The breed had two judges, males by, judged by Mrs. S. Clark, and bitches by Mrs. J. Entwistle. And they selected this male as best of breed, exhibit number 20259. Although shepherds in the hilly Scottish borders used collies for many years, this breed was not given its present name until 1915. The Border Collie is a highly intelligent dog and has the inborn instinct to work. The breed was originally used as a roaming sheepdog in the hills and mountains, mainly in the borders of border countries or counties of England, Scotland and Wales. Still the most popular working sheepdog in Great Britain and Ireland. That's the best of breed border collie, exhibit number 20259. Now we see the Briard. There was a breed entry of 108 by 95 exhibits, and breed judge Mr. W.J. Webb selected this bitch for best of breed, exhibit number 20694. The breed of Briard's ancient origins are unknown, but it was once classified as the goat hair variety of the Beauceron. It has been suggested it was developed by crossing that breed with the Bourbette. Also been called the Berger de Brie. The Briard originates from the province of Brie in France and has a dual role as a guard against marauding predators as well as a sheep herder. The Brie has also been occasionally employed as a pack dog, this among other general duties. Extrovert, loving to engage in games, which you can never turn rough, but never master. That's the best of breed Briard, exhibit number 20694. On the next of our pastoral breeds is the Rough Collie. Again, this was a breed that had two judges. Males were judged by Mr. J. D. Bispham, and bitches by Mr. A. R. Hodgson. It was a breed entry of 336 made by 283 exhibits, and our judges selected this male for best of breed, exhibit number 20924. The Rough Collie originated in its present form in the cold regions of northern Scotland. The ancient working Rough Collie was possibly shorter in leg and nose than today's elegant breed. It is thought to have evolved around 1800, and dogs brought originally to Scotland by the Romans, which were then mated with native types of working dog. The Rough Collie is a somewhat refined version of the original working collie of the Scottish Shepherd, from which it has been selected and bred over at least 100 years. As a result, we now see a glamorous show dog which draws its popularity from its impressive appearance. Though it should not be forgotten, the collie is a working dog. It's never be dismissed as just a pretty face. That's the best of breed Rough Collie, exhibit number 20924. And now we see the smooth collie. Mrs. B. Geddes was the breed judge. There was a breed entry of 87, made by 73 exhibits. And Mrs. Geddes selected this bitch's best of breed, exhibit number 20989. The smooth collie can trace its roots back to a tri-coloured puppy named Trefoil, which was born in 1873. Smooth collie in lots of ways is the same as the rough collie, with the exception of coat length, of course. The smooth has a short and flat coat with a harsh texture on a dense undercoat. The colour range is the same as the rough collie, although you tend to see more blue males in smooths than roughs. This breed makes a good companion. It's suited for a life in the country or city. That's the best of breed smooth collie, exhibit number 20989. Here we have the Australian Mountain Dog. Mr. Ernest Quinney was the breed judge. There was a breed entry of 31 made by 27 exhibits. And Mr. Quinney selected this bitch for best of breed, exhibit number 21079. This most potted of all the Portuguese breeds is one of the oldest on the Iberian Peninsula. It is descended from ancient mastiffs. Asiatic mastiff brought to the West is related to the Spanish mastiff. The Estrela mountain ranges in the central part of Portugal, where the Estrela mountain dog has been developed. It's a prop guarding dog. The breed is relatively easily trainable on the basis of good canine behavior. This is our best of breed Estrela mountain dog, exhibit number 21079. See the Finnish Lapland. The breed was judged today by Mrs. H.M. Head, and it was a breed entry of 73 made by 55 exhibits. And this bitch was selected as best of breed, exhibit number 21089. As the name denotes, the country of origin is Finland. Also been called the Lapin Koira. He's a spitz type, and his thick jacket comes in all manner of colours and enables him to cope with the harsh climate of Lapland. That's the best of breed Finnish Lapland, exhibit number 21089. And now the next breed to be seen by Mrs. Bambury is the German Shepherd Dog. Mr. T. Stambra is the breed judge. It was a breed entry of 190 made by 155 exhibits. Mr. Stambra selected this male for best of breed, exhibit number 21218. The German Shepherd Dog is arguably the most popular breed, not only in the United Kingdom, but worldwide. Shepherd, as the breed is affectionately known, was founded at the end of the 1800s. The German cavalry captain, Rittmeister Max von Stepenitz, has been credited as the father of the breed. The breed has been used as a herding dog, developed as a police and military dog, and rates with the best as a guide dog for the blind. A highly intelligent breed, needs to be kept occupied. This is our best of breed German Shepherd Dog, exhibit number 21218. Now we see one of the rarer breeds of the pastoral group, the Hungarian Kuvach. Mr. M.S. Quinney was the breed judge, and he selected this bitch's best of breed, exhibit number 21297. Some authorities believe that this great white guard dog arrived in Hungary in the 1100s with the Cumans, nomadic Turkish shepherds, and was first mentioned as a breed in the 1600s. The Kuvach is an independent, powerful dog used for protection of crops and livestock in Hungary by nomadic herdsmen. It has also been adapted to become a guard dog for people and property. That's the best of breed Hungarian Kuvach, exhibit number 21297. Now on the table we have the Hungarian Thule. Mr. I.H. Crowther was the breed judge. There was a breed entry of 49 made by 44 exhibits. Mr. Crowther selected this bitch for best of breed, exhibit number 21298. Thule was probably brought to Hungary by the Magyars, and today's Thule comes mainly from a breeding program carried out in this country. There is no mistaking the Hungarian Thule, although to the casual observer, they get confused as to which way the dog is heading. The most notable feature of the breed is its corded coat, so important to keep him warm and dry from the intense weather. Well, he carries out his duties as a herder of flocks of sheep in his native Hungary. Exhibit number 21298. And now, out of the ring, we have the Commodore. Mr. O.J. Stonskier was the breed judge. Mr. Stonskier comes from Denmark, and from an entry of 7, he selected this bitch as best of breed. Exhibit number 21346. Commodore is another breed which hails from Hungary and is used as a guarding dog for herds and flocks on the farm. It is thought that this is the largest of the Hungarian herdsmen dogs, accompanying the Magyar tribes from the east when they settled in Hungary over 1,000 years ago. First mentioned by name in 1544, it was not until around 1910 that the Commodore was firmly established as a modern breed. And here we see the best of breed Commodore, exhibit number 21346. And now on the table we have the Lancashire Healer. This is S.A. Wybrow, the breed judge. There was a breed entry of 89 made by 82 exhibits. And this male was selected as best of breed, exhibit number 21390. This little fella originates from the time when cattle were herded and driven from Wales by corgis to be sold in markets in the Ormskirk area. So you can imagine when the Welsh herder, that the local Manchester Terrier, the Lancashire Healer is said to have been the result. Certainly the breed was found in the Lancashire area of northern England and was bred there as long ago as the 1600s, but it did become extinct in the late 1800s, but was regenerated in the 1960s. That's the best of breed Lancashire Healer, exhibit number 21390. And now we see the Maremma Sheepdog. Mrs. S. Kirk Chambers was the breed judge, and from an entry of 11, she selected this male as best of breed, exhibit number 21438. This is another of the rare pastoral breeds here in the United Kingdom. Today's Maremma sheepdog is the descendant of the shorter-coated Maremmano sheepdog and the longer-bodied Abruzzese mountain dog. This is a breed that is still used in Italy to guard the shepherd's flocks. He's named after the plains of Maremma, which have been used for centuries by shepherds and farmers as grazing land. It's believed to be descended from the white working dogs of the Magyars. But the breed was still relatively rare until 1976, when efforts were made to import and breed good stock. This is a highly intelligent breed. The Maremma Sheepdog best of breed, exhibit number 21438. And now we see the Norwich and Bulland. Mr. S. Hall was the breed judge. There was a pre-entry of 67 made by 55 exhibits. And this male was selected in Best of Breed, exhibit number 21456. The Norwegian bullhund was originally used to pull sleds and as a hunter companion. It now serves as a herder, a guard dog, and a companion. The Norwegian bullhund is a typical spitz with his pointed face and erect ears. Used as an alert guard and efficient herder in his native Norway, the bullhund is one of the earliest known Nordic herding dogs. That's the best of breed Norwegian bullhund, exhibit number 21456. And here we see the Old English sheepdog. This is Anthony Summerfield as a breed judge. It was a breed entry of 184 made by 168 exhibits. And this is Summerfield selected as Bitch's best of breed, exhibit number 21642. The Old English sheepdog probably traces its origins back to continental sheepdogs, such as the Briard. Selective breeding began in the 1800s. The Old English sheepdog is regarded as a native British breed and was often affectionately known as the bobtail. Although the tail often been banned, his old nickname doesn't really apply anymore. Profuse coat is a distinctive feature of the breed. It's weather resistant, but does need plenty of time and patience for grooming by its owner. Exhibit number 21642. And next to be seen by Mrs. Banbury is the Tullowy Shiloba Sheepdog. This is A. Arch, who's the breed judge. There was a breed entry of 63 made by 60 exhibits. And Mrs. Arch selected this male for best of breed, exhibit number 21685. As the name implies, the breed's country of origin is Poland. Is affectionately known as Puss. It is said the breed originally came to Britain in the 16th century when the sailors from Gdansk exchanged their dogs for other animals at their Scottish ports of call. The breed has a long history and derives from the Hungarian Thule and other native brown-coated herding dogs of Poland. Been used as a herding dog since the 1500s. That's the best of breed Tullowy Shiloba sheepdog, exhibit number 21685. And here we see the Pyrenean Mountain Dog. Mr. A. White was the breed judge. There was a breed entry of 130 made by 101 exhibits. Now Mr. White selected this male is best to breed, yes, exhibit number 21732. One of the great white guarding mastiffs, this is spread across Europe. This magnificent breed is probably related to the Italian Maremma, Hungarian Kuvash, Slovakian Kuva, and the Turkish Karabakh. It thrived principally in Andorra before it was discovered early in the 20th century. His home is in the Pyrenean mountain range in France, where he's known as the Great Pyrenees. uses a guard dog, the Jeremy Bantu dog, has been protecting flocks in France for centuries. He's a very gentle side to his nature, and is affectionate and tolerant with children. That's the Pyrenean Mountain Dog Best of Breed, exhibit number 21732. Now we see the Pyrenean Sheepdog. Mr. F.J. Randall was the breed judge. There was a breed entry of 28 made by 24 exhibits, and Mr. Randall selected this bitch for Best of Breed, exhibit number 21837. The Pyrenean Sheepdog is a French breed and originates in the Pyrenees. It's a small, energetic sheepdog which has been selectively bred to herd large flocks of sheep in rural areas. The Pyrenean Sheepdog has a strong herding instinct and is a highly intelligent breed. It has tremendous energy and stamina for its size. That's the Best of Breed Pyrenean Sheepdog, exhibit number 21837. Now we have the Best of Breed Samoyed. Ms. Anne Morgan was the original breed judge. Unfortunately, she was taken ill during judging and Anne Arch took over the judging duties. And from an entry of 195 made by 173 exhibits, this bitch was selected as Best of Breed. Exhibit number 21915. This breed is truly the canine equivalent of the Laughing Cavalier. And as the breed standard requires, it has a smiling expression. The Samoyed has developed from dogs used for centuries as sled dog and herding dog, and took the breed name from the nomadic tribes of Siberia, with whom it lived and worked for centuries. The breed was introduced into the West in around 1889. The breed is known affectionately as the Sammy. It's good-natured, alert, intelligent, and full of action. It's the Best of Breed Samoyed, exhibit number 21915. Moving back to the table, we now have the Shetland Sheepdog. This is another of our classical breeds who have two judges. Males were judged by Mrs. N. Glover Guest, and bitches by Mr. R. Jeff Thomas. There was an overall breed entry of 399 made by 338 exhibits. And the judges jointly selected this bitch's best of breed, exhibit number 22312. This is a breed that originates from the Shetland Islands in the northeast of Scotland, an area that laid claim to a number of animals which are small in stature. The breed may be the result of crossing imported rough collies with dogs from the Scottish Shetland Islands and was originally known as the Shetland Collie. The name was changed in 1908 when the Shetland Sheepdog Club was formed. It was a Shetlander called Logie who standardised the breed for the show ring, and it was first entered at Gruffs in 1906, where it was shown and scheduled as a miniature collie. Sometimes called a Sheltie, this is an affectionate, intelligent, and particularly active breed. It's the Best of Breed Shetland Sheepdog, exhibit number 22312. Now we have the Swedish Valpehund. Ms. Jean Manning was the breed judge. There was a breed entry of 67 made by 67 exhibits. Ms. Manning selected this male for Best of Breed, exhibit number 22396. The Valhund is also called the Swedish cattle dog, identifying both his country of origin and his purpose. In shape and temperament, this breed is similar to the Tender Corgi. It's likely that this multi-purpose drover, watchdog and ratter arrived in Scandinavia with the Vikings who had previously settled in Pembrokeshire in Wales. The breed nearly disappeared in the 1930s, mainly due to the efforts of Count Bjorn von Rosen, who was saved and was recognised by the Swedish Kennel Club in 1948. The breed was granted recognition in Britain in 1984. Very active and good guard from the point of view of giving warnings of an approaching stranger. Has had a friendly, cheerful disposition and always ready for exercise. It's the best of breed Swedish Valhund, exhibit number 22396. Now on the table we have the Cardigan Welsh Corgi. This is K.A. Littlefair as the breed judge. And there is a breed entry of 74 made by 63 exhibits. Mrs. Littlefair selected his bitch's best of breed, exhibit number 22478. Some authorities say that this breed arrived in Great Britain with the Celts over 3,000 years ago. Also known as the yard dog, because of the length from the tip of the nose to the end of the outstretched tail, is the measurement for a Welsh yard. The Cardi has a more restful character than his cousin. It's the Pembroke Corgi, but is very capable of great activity and energy when ever called upon. This is a breed which is loyal, affectionate, and is extremely good at being intruder alarm. Corgi is nowhere a Pembroke Corgi with a tail, although the two varieties back from a common rootstock. Time has developed each breed to have obvious construction and coat differences. The Cardigan Corgi is thought to be the older of the two varieties, with history going back to around 1200. It's the best of breed, Cardigan Welsh Corgi, exhibit number 22478. We now come to the final breed in the pastoral group, the Pembroke Welsh Corgi. Breed being judged today by Mr. S.J. Parsons, an entry of 188 made by 160 exhibits. And Mr. Parsons selected this bitch for best of breed, exhibit number 22611. Ancient records indicate the Pembroke Welsh Corgi has existed in Great Britain since at least AD 920. One story tells of a breed accompanied Flemish weavers brought to Great Britain by King Henry I of England. A favourite of our Queen, his prick ears and his lovely features, giving an appearance of being interested in everything that is going on around him. Which belies his small stature. His lungs are obviously built to give him the stamina needed to do a day's work on a farm. Pembroke Corgi is also nimble enough to get out of the way of attack free kicks from the cow subject to the Pembroke Corgi's herding instinct, a thoroughly practical breed which can live with all sorts of households, from fauna and to royalty. This is our best of breed Pembroke Welsh Corgi, exhibit number 22611. examination of our pastoral breeds having been completed by Mrs. Banbury. Just another quick look around the lineup before she goes into selecting her shortlist. As I said earlier, these are the finalists of an entry of 710 pastoral breeds here at Crufts 2009. It's a dollar roll entry of 22,677. This entry being the third highest that Crust has received. This is the normal group judging procedure. Mrs. Banbury completes her final look around the breeds. You will go back to the beginning of the line to start filling out their shortlist. Which is normally usually around about 8 exhibits. Just another quick look at the Savoyard. This is one of the 31 pastoral breeds represented here in the ring tonight. Every one of our exhibitors hoping that they're going to be that seventh finalist for the Best in Show judging later this evening. As expected, Mrs. Banbury swiftly goes back to the start of our line. So wait now for our shortlist. Out comes the Australian Shepherd. The Border Collie. Don Gavin Cooley. The Miranda Sheepdog. The Old English Sheepdog. The Pyrenean Mountain Dog. The Shetland Sheepdog. The Cardigan Welsh Corgi and the Pembroke Welsh Corgi. So that concludes our shortlist. And again, can I ask you to show your appreciation to our other festival breeds here in the Pastoral Group Crufts 2009 as they leave the room. So we have a shortlist of 9 breeds here in the Pastoral Group Crufts 2009. As they retreat to the end of our ring, they will all be, again be individually moved by Mrs. Banbury. The first to be moved is the Australian Shepherd, exhibit number 19517. The breed was judged today by Mrs. S. Cook. And now off goes the Border Collie, exhibit number 20259. The breed was judged today by Mrs. S. Clark and Mrs. J. Entwistle. And now we see the Hungarian Cooley, exhibit number 21298. Reed is joined today by Mr. R.H. Crowther. And finally, the Pembroke Welsh Corgi, 22611. And the breed has been judged today by Mr. S.J. Parsons. Seventh finalist for this evening's Best in Show judging. Decisions made, I think. It's going to be the Old English Sheepdog. Winner of the Pastoral Green Grants 2009, the Old English Sheepdog, exhibit number 21642. Working group 2 is the Pembroke Welsh Corgi. 22611. Working group 3 is the Hungarian Corgi, exhibit 21298. National group 4 for the following 20259. So we have our finalists. Again, can I ask you to show your appreciation to our other shortlisted breeds from the Pastoral River, the ring and being congratulated by Mrs. Brenda Bamber. So again, as Mrs. Bamber returns to her witness, as we need to introduce the person to present our awards. think the award's going to be made. And the person to make that is Mickey Paul, president of the British Veterinary Association, escorted into the ring by Mr. Eric Smethurst, the chairman of press, of course. So the trophy for the winner of the Pastoral Group Press 2009 goes to the English Old English Sheepdog, exhibit number 21642.
What does it mean to you?
Oh, everything. Oh, I can't even say it right now. I'm just
glad you like that, and I hope you have time to relax before Best in Show. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, your group winner.
So our winners will do their Apple Honor and set off, of course, by the winner of the Pastoral Group Press 2009, the Old English Sheepdog, 21642.